Borrowing costs for Indian companies have risen to three-year highs after India's worst economic slowdown in 9 years. CRISIL, for instance, cut the rating for 15 companies in the first quarter, and it also finds that only 4 Indian companies were upgraded for every 10 downgrades. That's the worst ratio since 2007. Remember that S&P and Fitch have already cut their outlook for the sovereign rating. This sets the context for this discussion. Joining me, Sergey Dergashev, who helps manage $8.5 billion in emerging market funds at Union Investment Private Fund from Frankfurt. Hemant Darni Darka, Managing Director and Head of Credit Research of SJS Markets from Bangalore. Gentlemen, many thanks for joining in. Sergey, I'll start with you. Do you believe that Indian companies continue to run the risk as growth slows down? Hemant, you know, on one hand is the pressure of downgrades. On the other, we've seen growth falling down. You're seeing interest rate costs quite up. Do you see this pressure building on Indian companies?
Absolutely. When you look from the current scenario, the growth has been going down, the inflation has been increasing, and the interest rates haven't come down. If the inflation continues to remain high, even though the numbers came in at a little over 7% yesterday, the inflation number is still high, so we can't have interest rate cuts anytime soon. Another thing we have to look at it is that India is rated BBB-, which is the lowest investment grade rating. So in case there is a downgrade by one notch, it will immediately go from investment grade to junk. And then there are a lot of pension funds which invest only in nations which are investment grade. So that could have a more than proportionate impact in case there is a downgrade from current levels.
Sergey, how concerned are you about the deteriorating credit quality of Indian companies?
Additional funding costs.
Hemant, how do you see bonds behaving right now? You know, we've seen the fact that international investors have been cutting down their holdings in bond positions by $983 million, we're told. What is the sense that you're getting on how investors are positioned right now?
See, if you look at the bond issuances which were due for maturity in 2012, most of them were convertibles where the corporates had not really expected to pay. They were expecting that all of the bonds will be converted. But as it happened is that the stock prices were much lower than the conversion price, and hence the bonds were not converted at all. Some of the bigger names, Reliance Communication, Tata Steel, JSW, they have gone ahead and paid off their bonds as and when they fell due for maturity. On the other hand, some companies like Subex, 3i Infotech, these companies have forcefully extended their bond maturity by another 5 years. There are a few more companies in the pipeline like Mozabea, which have their bonds coming up for maturity, and the bond market doesn't really expect that the company will be able to repay. Now, when a bondholder is forced to extend his maturity, he normally asks for a higher yield. That results in the yields on all the bonds in general going up, because when my clients outside India look at India, they say that, you know what, you can never be sure whether the bonds will be paid on time. So to adjust for that risk, we need a higher return. Hence, I don't really see the spreads coming down for companies in India in general. At the same time, Reliance is an exception because Reliance has its bond issuances coming out of its US subsidiary, in which case it is not struck by the sovereign ceiling. The Reliance bonds are rated BBB, which is better than the sovereign rating of BBB-.
Right.
Going forward, if India was to go to junk, right, Reliance will be one of the very few companies which could still continue to be at an investment grade rating. So those companies, Tata Motors, again, if they were to begin issuing out of their JLR subsidiaries they have done in the past,
right,
they'll be able to tap the market more easily, but not others.
Very quickly, Hemant, you know, we're seeing very little investment spending happening. People aren't raising money in that sense. This is largely about servicing existing debt. And do you expect the situation to get worse before it gets better?
See, the situation could get a bit worse for some of the companies. But overall, I think the Indian company should be able to pay off the interest and roll over the debt. In some cases, if you look at Reliance Communication, it got a new loan of $1 billion from a Chinese bank and paid off the bonds. We would expect a lot more rollovers, some voluntary, some involuntary, but we don't really see too many defaults where the bondholder will be left with just a piece of paper and not get anything back.
Sergey, last word with you. All right, gentlemen, we'll have to leave it there. Sergey Dergashev, Hemant Darni Darka, many thanks for joining us with your perspective on top-rated